We've always been impressed by all things Lotus, so it's no surprise we were eager to get our hands on a 2006 Lotus Exige modified by Secant vehicles. Our Type 1 modified Exige has been outfitted with GM's supercharged and intercooled 2-liter Ecotec inline 4. The Secant modified Ecotec engine is enhanced with a forged crank and rods, sodium-cooled valves, and a smaller supercharger pulley for increased boost. On paper, the increase in performance looks impressive. We figure the peak power we measured at the wheels of 210 horsepower equates to roughly 260 horsepower at the flywheel. But looking closely at the dyno result, the power peak arrived right at the 6,300 RPM fuel cutoff, 650 RPM shy of where the red line is supposed to be. Had our test car pulled all the way to the 7,000 RPM rev limit, it would have come close to achieving the 280 horsepower that Secant quoted. But there's more to the Type 1 Exige than a souped-up powertrain. Secant has tweaked the electronics so you can switch the engine control map for different fuel octane ratings. In theory, you can fill up at the corner station or run the Type 1 Exige on a racing fuel of 100 octane or better. Problem is, the Secant Exige has been developed for the 93 octane premium pump gas of Detroit instead of our 91 octane premium in California, so we had to mix race gas in the tank to get the car to run properly. We think this is a deal breaker for those who expect this Exige to be a street car. With the race gas setting engaged, the Exige ripped consistently from 0 to 60 in the low 4-second range. Our best was 4 seconds flat from a standing start and 3.8 seconds with a 1-foot rollout. The Exige tears through the quarter mile in 12.5 seconds at 107.7 miles per hour, much faster than a normally aspirated Elise. Braking was much more impressive. The Secant Exige screeched to a halt from 60 in a mere 103 feet thanks to its excellent Brembo brake package and track-ready Toyo R-Spec tires. But there is such a thing as too much rubber. The Secant's 225-45 R17 front tires are so big that they rub noisily on the fenders. Slalom speed also suffered. We were only able to record a pass at 70.9 miles per hour, compared to 74 miles per hour in the stock Exige S. Perhaps the most daunting thing about the Secant Exige is the price tag. Once you factor in the price of a stock Lotus Exige, then factor in all the Secant upgrades, the total comes to more than $91,000. We think Secant's conversion might be great for an older Exige or Elise, but in most cases, all that money for so little performance just doesn't pay off.